In this short video, we will explain the importance of sterile and aseptic cell culture handling. Following these guidelines will save you a lot of frustrations and time wasted due to culture contamination. The two most common contamination sources are bacterial contamination and mycoplasma contamination. The main difference between the two are the sizes. While bacterial cells are several micrometers in size and therefore can be easily removed using 0.22 micrometer filter such as this one, some mycoplasma is as small as 0.2 micrometer and can even go through 0.22 micrometer filter pores. That is why mycoplasma contamination is so common. Due to the small size, mycoplasma contamination can be difficult to identify at early stages. Only later on, the cell culture media becomes cloudy, and when looking through the microscope, the media and cells will not look as clean as usual. Of course, the best way to deal with both mycoplasma and bacterial infection is to not have it in the first place. Following the next guidelines will ensure a sterile working environment and will minimize the chances of cell culture contamination. First, sterile work area. The best way to reduce the chance of contamination is to use biosafety cabinet to avoid airborne particles and aerosols. Before and after each use, routinely swipe the work surface with 70% ethanol. 2. Personal hygiene. Make sure to wash your hands before and after cell culture and also wear protective equipment like latex gloves to reduce contamination from skin as well as dirt and dust from your clothes. 3. Sterile reagents and media. Commercial reagents and media are sterile but can be contaminated during handling. Always sterilize any reagent, media or solution prepared with appropriate sterilization procedure. For example, use of autoclave and sterile filter. 4. Sterile handling. Always wipe your hands and work area with 70% ethanol. Wipe all the equipment with 70% ethanol before placing them in a biosafety cabinet. Avoid pouring media and reagent directly from bottle or flask. And be careful not to talk when you are performing a procedure. Perform the experiment as rapidly as possible to minimize any chance for contamination. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. And again, if you have any questions, please feel free to contact us.